If you want to expand the network to a new location, what is the first thought come up in your mind? Just grab a new switch, connect the second switch to the first switch. Later, you may need to have first switch to connect the second switch. Eventually, you are going to have a daisy chain network. In this video, I'm going to talk about why daisy chain is not a good practical network, and also give some advice how to put all these switches together properly. Before we jump to the video, I would love if you can click the like button below. It really helps if the YouTube algorithm and show the people who really need this video. So why daisy chain is not good? The first problem is the single failing point. We put all these switches in line. If one of the switch goes down, we are going to lose all the switch after this one, including all the device connecting to the switch. It increases the chance to lose more device than star topology. The second thing is to increase the challenge to diagnose the system. If there are any problem come up with one IP device, in the star topology, you can just disconnect the cable linking to that switch, then you can see whether the system is still working or not. But in the daisy chain network, you cannot remove any of the switch, otherwise you're going to lose a lot of IP device, including the network. The next thing is about the latency. When we connect all these switch together, then the data need to transmit from the last switch to the first switch. Let's say we have connected IP camera from the last switch, the fifth switch. Before the camera go to the network video recorder, you need to go through all the switch. More importantly, the switch need to look for the address table to figure out which port to send the data. Then it will increase the time. If the latency is too long, it also will increase the data loss. You are going to see the video jumping on your monitor. If daisy chain is inevitable, what should we do? Now let's move to the demonstration wall and see how we can do the best for the daisy chain network. This is the typical daisy chain network. Here we have the core switch. The core switch is connecting to the router to have the internet accessing from the ISP provider. The second switch is connected to the core switch. The first switch is connecting to the second switch. We may have more switch and IP device after third switch. If I just remove the cable from the third switch, then we are going to lose all the IP device and network switch after second switch. This is called single failing point. It also increases the challenge to diagnose the system, figure out which IP device or switch caused the issue. So what's the advice? The first advice is try your best to avoid the daisy chain network if you still can, even if it's going to cost you more money. Let's take this for example. What I need to do is bring the cable and connect this cable to the core switch. Then let's move to the first switch. Then connect it to the first switch. Remember, we also need to remove the cable between the second switch and the third switch. Otherwise, it's going to create a loop. It's not going to work. In this setup, we are going to go back to the star topology. Both switch is connecting to the core switch. So if there's anything wrong, what you need to do is just remove the cable to one of the switch. Then you can figure out whether that switch caused the issue or not. The latency will be lower. There's no need for the data from the first switch to the second switch, then go back to the core switch. All the switch will go back to the core switch directly. If we cannot pull the cable from the first switch to the core switch, we still can optimize the daisy chain setup. Now let's just swap these two switch and see what will happen. First, I'm going to remove the core switch from the router. And then I'm going to get the second switch and put this switch just next to the router. And here we got the core switch. Let's put all the cable back. You see, we have the core switch is connecting to the third switch and the first switch. Now, if from this core switch, we got the start topology. All the things connecting to the core switch, right? But still one thing, you may need the Ethernet accessing from the first switch. So what we can do, you just need to put the cable from the router, it could be a network video recorder, then connect to the core switch. You just need one cable and place this core switch at the middle of the daisy chain network. It's going to shorten the distance between each end to the core switch. Let's say there's 5 switches in this daisy chain network, and this is the IP camera system. The video from the IP camera in the last switch need to go through all these 5 switches before it can find the network video recorder on the first switch. By set the core switch at the middle of the daisy chain, we reduce the network switch path from 5 switches to 3 switches. It will cut down the latency between the IP camera and network video recorder. If you need to set up the daisy chain just because the distance is beyond 328 feet between this switch, you can reference my another video, how to use the run-run PoE network to set up to 1060 feet continuous run network.